Dr. Nalkish, Professor and Head Department of Physiotherapy, Punjabi University, Patiala, with the request of Haryana Chartered Society of Physiotherapy, Ravindra Murgil requested, Dr. Ravindra Murgil requested to take in a class of webinar on knee joint. So what I am going to teach you in this corona time, the first of all, I wish everyone, a physio and a physio family and a whole Indian family, the world, everyone is stay safe in the home and blessed and healthy. First of all, the important is, especially for physio, we need to become more and more strong in immune system. So once again, I request everyone, use mask and hand glove and specs especially, because the coronavirus entered into the body through eyes, through nose, through the mouth. So we take care of them. Whenever we connected with the patient, we should ask the screening protocol and as well as the Indian government making of Sedu app downloaded for your healthy status. Come to the point, how we can become more stronger in the coronavirus against. One is take vitamin C or 500 two times per day, and vitamin D3 you can take. So these all are give improve your vitamin system as well as the immune system, and drink plenty of water and breathe well, as well as the my old video is I'm going to launch how to tap your thymus gland. Please go through my YouTube channel, you can find out how to activate the thymus to improve your the immune system as well as stay stronger. Here today we are going to study about the knee pain and the knee, one of the biggest challenges in India. In all and all physios, we are thinking about if a knee pain give hot pack or cold pack, IST or TENS, SWD and isometric quadriceps. There is a lot of myth in present in physiotherapy, because in last 30 years we have a lot of research with the evidences, we can practice much better. Let's learn, because our crowd, especially in the same people in the different level, not only physio, students also. So some of the portion maybe you feel it is the basic, yes, because of our the listener, especially viewer, it from BPT first year to BPT fourth year, practitioner and expert. So that I'm divided into three level. The first one is the basic for all, needed to know the basic anatomy, biomechanics, then few cases of discuss the clinical and manual methods, how to treat in a different cases. So we have the different categories to go ahead. Let's see the PPT of how you can get a knee pain and classification. The knee complex is one of the complex. It is more functional than the structure. This it is work and a more and warranty of the lifestyle. So the disease is not related to any age group, anyone. The recent research said the knee pain and a degeneration have no relation. If seen in an X-ray, the exact normal X-ray with the severe knee pain seen in an area. Once again, I'm proud to say I'm Dr. Nalkish and Punjabi University give me a platform to do a lot of research, clinical work, as well as graduate, postgraduate and PhD studies. So important to word to hear, your ability to heal is come from your knowing that you will heal. That means you your learning portion, it's a lifetime learning. So you have to learn till death, especially in the medical field. So I appreciate everyone, come here and learn this new one. In this picture, you can come to know this candle is refusing the bulb. Yes, the last 30 years of in my life, I'm seeing a lot of new come up. So open mind, whatever I'm speaking with the area with is evidence based, let's accept for the betterment of clinical methods as well as use of the patient considered. So you cannot reach anything new if you have had are still full of yesterday junk. That means the updated method we have to open, remove our concept. Like example, isometrics is helping or not. The recent article is available in Physio Times. Go on three. Still we are using outdated method. The most of the area we are physios are temporary comfort, we spoiling our many things, especially referring the cases of conservative management into the surgical and needed, which condition is required, we can more and more conservative management is next. So what are the condition we are going to discuss? One is anatomy, biomechanics, soft tissue, bony disorder, knee joint, then question and answer as from the association is going to take care. So if you have any queries, you can talk to me in any stage of end of the classes. I will be available in the online and you can area. Little deeper clinical conditions, but the maneuver is few or more in common condition. The knee joint divided into two portions. One is called bony structure, another one is soft tissue. The bony structure consider three bone in most important: femur, tibia and patella, the muscle, ligaments, bursa and meniscus. The basic what to want to say, we have biomechanics, osteokinematics and arthrokinematics. Also, there is a kinesiology work, muscular, and that the most important ligament injury seen and meniscus injury seen with the sports and the normal life. The bony structure, you can see here, the tibia femoral joint are shown and in the green structures, and tibia femoral surfaces mentioned in above femur. You can see these are the articulating surfaces in work. That especially the distal articulation with the patella allow the tendon of quadriceps inserted directly over the knee joint increase efficiency of the muscle. So these are the muscle, we can go through it because we have the limited time, you learn it, origin, insertion, apply. These are the most important muscle we is going to work with knee joint. And the further biceps femoris, semitendinosus, popliteus, gastrocnemius, plantaris and gracilis also work with the knee joint. So come to here, we see the anterior aspect of the knee joint. Here the most important one to say, ACL and PCL, you see the both are helping in translating anterior, controlling anterior translation and controlling posterior translation during the flexion and extension. Especially you see medial meniscus is very close attached with medial collateral ligament. And the most common ligament and most common meniscus is get injured. These are the important of the different ligaments and how it's work. We have anterior cruciate, posterior cruciate, medial meniscus, medial collateral ligament, lateral collateral ligament and coronary ligament. The coronary ligament we very rarely listen, but it's articular margin, the margin problem, and control the attachment with the meniscus with the TV. If it is relaxed, the meniscus movement is increased. So here once again, the anterior ACL is helping limit the anterior translation, PCL is helping limit the posterior translation, medial collateral ligament is limit valgus force, lateral ligament is limit vara force. Next. The bursa, the one which is misalignment of the bone, especially tibia, femur and patella, that will be a friction at the bursa and get inflammation, that is called bursitis. But we should know what are the bursa is available. Suprapatella bursa, above the patella level, prepatella in the anterior, the most common, the person with mopping of the floors and kneeling down and the prey down, these are the most common we get injury. Then infrapatellar bursa is a deeper and as well as superficial split into two portions, and semimembranous is located posterior to the knee joint between the semimembranous muscle and the medial head of gastrocnemius. Sometimes it's involved. Come to the medial meniscus and lateral meniscus. It is both are the C shape, but you should know the lateral meniscus is highly mobile, so less chance to injury. But the posterior, the medial meniscus, which is attached with the medial collateral ligament as well as anterior horn, that's why the medial meniscus get more and more get involved. Next. It is also supplied by the two blood supply. One is from the femoral, another one is tibial. Nerve supplies come up, as well as it is by femoral and popliteal arteries given a vascular supply. The capsule is wide and lacks thin in this area. The capsule had a strong role in shoulder, in especially in knee joint, synovial membrane had a strong role to perform. Mechanics of the knee joint. The knee biomechanics divided into two portions. One is called tibia femoral, another one is patellofemoral joint. And here tibia femoral arthrokinematic and osteokinematic work. Patellofemoral is its slide forward, medial and lateral and superior. Where we will see in the further. Next. The tibia femoral osteokinematic, it considered to be in a flexion 130 to 150 and hyperextension 5 to 10 degree. And it is also rotate tibia, that means internally rotation of 0 to 50 degree and extrolation 0 to 30 degree. Rotation based originator of tibia tuberosity based. also the passive ventricle the motion, that is the adduction of the tibia can see. These are the tibiofemoral arthrokinematic, it generally called roll, glide, spin, in seen in the primary. The ACL one, the especially ACL ligament, tension increase during flexion, initiate anterior femoral glide or translation. So it control anterior, especially in PCL, it control the translation of posterior. The remaining you see a concave convex method of area, you can go further. Next, come to the most important, we will see the rarely patellofemoral joint motion between the patella facet and femoral girdle. So here it's most importantly come to know, that means the patella flexion and extension, tilt and shift and rotated in multiple work. I see here I introduce here the most important to say, there is a most friction seen in a lateral portion. When it is superior motion, superior lateral and medial, the two different. So why you come to name, when the patella is slide, it always superior and lateral, inferior and medial. So when you see the different type of flexion, when the patient complained, end range extension is painful in patella femoral, that means this is inferior portion. Extreme flexion is problem, that is superior portion. So we have the different type of patella tracking seen in these cases. Next, the screw home mechanism seen, the slight external rotation of 15 degree knee due to inequality of articular surface because of medial and lateral condyle is not in the same bulge and same surfaces. So is result vastus medialis oblique and vastus lateralis a muscle function. Here important to say, the popliteus is helping unlock the knee joint and both ligaments control the translation. So the skew home mechanism means locking and unlocking mechanism. Next, the other conditions come to in front of you, that is a knee joint pain can be classified by anterior, medial and or lateral and posterior and generalized. Start with generalized, the infection, osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, gout and pseudo gout generally seen. But anterior, the maximum is condition is related to patella femoral pain, patella tendinitis and patella subluxation, osteochondritis dissection and tibial apophytes. Both are the secondary center inflammation, means the changes of inflammation seen in adolescent boys and girls especially. The medial and lateral is commonly seen with collateral ligament, meniscus, iliotibial or friction syndrome, it is also called Rennerscombe, Pease and Serrain bursitis, medial plica syndrome and medial condylar osteonecrosis. And posterior it is popliteus, it is also called a Becker cyst, and posterior cruciate ligament injury can seen in a different four different one. When you're talking about the patella femoral, it is by the muscular imbalance, the most malalignment and overactivity. If it is the both are it's misaligned, we can get patellar flexion syndrome. Is generally the contralmalacia patella word, it is only authorized when it is seen through arthroscopy or MRI. Otherwise it is called patellofemoral tracking syndrome, friction syndrome or slide or dysfunction. These are the most important word. If it is a patella tendon get inflammation due to the misalignment and miswork, it is called jumper's knee and an irritation inflammation of tendon seen, commonly acquired in the teenagers, boys seen and work. And today we have the manual how to diagnose as well as how to correct in the patella femoral in anterior knee pain. It is also called osteochondritis, Osgood, Schulter disease. These are the called inflammatory and a poor position chondritis, recalcification. We seen in a different work. Here especially we go through it, the basic is mechanical symptom of locking, catching of knee and quadriceps atrophy seen in osteochondritis and dissections, and radiology and MRI can identify very well. Inflammation of patella ligament and the tuberosity apophysitis, that means there is an inflammation of tibial tuberosity very prominently seen, especially in adolescent girls and boys we commonly see. Next, patella subluxation, it subluxed and shifted one, the more often in girls, the young woman because of the increased quadriceps Q angle.
So especially we study Q angles, Q angle to be in a major role of valgus and barum of knee joint. So that we can correct it. Yes, we can correct it by braces, muscular imbalances and insole. We can make it done very well. There will be a effusion seen. If it is effusion is symptomatic, we can go with cold pack and everything. But mechanical is correction is our work. Next. The medial lateral pain is a ligament injury. We commonly seen with the valgus varus strain, inability of presence, and radiography is not required because of clinically we can diagnose this case by valgus stress and varus stress. Next. Medial lateral ligament here is one of the biggest myth in here. If you go for an MRI without any knee joint problem, without knee pain, that is to be a, more than 50% people get a medial meniscal CSC in the recent study said. So the pain and a ligament meniscal injury is not directly related except extreme lesions. Otherwise, if a meniscus is the variant here, it's generally seen, especially medial meniscus, which is correlated with the medial collateral ligament. It's by the misalignment of the knee joint can happen with area. The pes anserine bursitis, the tendon inserin sartorius gracilis and in semitendinosus. This is the most common anteromedial aspect of the proximal area. There is a contusion, an injury and an inflammation can produce bursitis, which is generally neglected by physios. We are not take care of this bursa. How to differentiate of tendinitis and bursa? Very simple. When you give a friction, if pain is aggravate, that's bursitis. If a friction reduce the pain, it is tendinitis. We can get differentiated clinically. Next, iliotibial tract syndrome. Today we have the manual how to release the iliotibial tract, because this one produce mid-knee stability, especially during running area. It is also called the runner syndrome. This muscle of iliotibial tract, it's formed by the two musculature. One is called tensor fasciae, the another one is called the gluteus maximus. TFL is 1/3, 2/3 of gluteus maximus together make this iliotibial tract and attach to the lateral area. The most common lateral friction syndrome seen in iliotibial tract syndrome. So today we have the manual how to correct in iliotibial syndrome, how to make the one. Then the medial plica syndrome, the acute trauma, repeated strain, some underlying disorder like meniscus, old injury and thickening. At tight, the bowstring impingement of the structure of synovial irritation and mobile nodular area. The present in the middle aspect of the knee joint. These are the medial plica can be corrected by our one of the manual we will going to show you. That is developed by it is still in osteopathic method. We will do how to correct of this. Next. The medial condylar osteonecrosis, we see systematic diseases, we see in a different of osteonecrosis. The next, posterior knee pain, that is a Becker cyst, we can say cyst of the area, most of the area, L5-1. And here is the most important one to say, the Becker cyst is develop too much of isometric exercise. So please, the physio, don't allow too much of isometric exercise. It can be swollen and fillable, palpable collection at the posterior aspect. And posterior cruciate ligament, one of the injury, it promote posterior translation. Generalized seen by infection, osteoarthritis, we have a separate session for osteoarthritis. Then we will go how to correct, how to get in the better way of feature. Rheumatoid arthritis, you know, that is a synovitis and a synovial contractile and shifting other one, and tuberculosis is one of the major common cause seen in especially developing countries. It's a secondary one, tuberculosis, pseudogout and gout because of the too much of urea, urate of crystals formation, but generally it affects first FTP joint is more commonly affected. Prosperophytes is common crystal seen in this agent. That's why called gout and pseudogouts. Next. Now we have this patellofemoral maneuver method. How to correct, how to check. So here Dr. Sriram come for as a volunteer to show how we can correct the patellofemoral. Lie down, Sriram, please. Hi friends, we are generally, we are see that is a knee joint, everyone is see. Just take a pin and mark the lower aspect of the patella and upper aspect of the patella. Very nicely we mark. Right. If you put a finger here and finger here, you see there is an asymmetry seen. One is lower, one is higher. this is lower, this is maybe higher, and maybe it's a normal, maybe down. So how we can find out? That is called graining test. Just put an area and do up and down. You have any crepitus? And say, wow, that is when a superior portion get crepitus here. That means you do excessive flexion. Excessive flexion will affect this all important one. How we can correct this? That means there may be some changes inside of the patella. So the patella one, the another one patella, we give a graining test here. Wow, and middle to lateral good and rotatory good. The graining test is negative here, graining test is positive here. As well as the patient say there is a pain at superior lateral portion. So here I want to know the biomechanics of the important. When you see this patella, when you cut this, the patella always go on this direction. This and this direction. As per our normally even in physiotherapy we study, it go superior, it go lateral, it go medial, it go down. But the condyle had a major role. The medial condyle, lateral condyle is likely. That's why it's more towards superior lateral and inferior medial. So now you can see the patella is lateral. This one method is called applied kinesiology method. So now I want to show how to check. We say one hand, it's a dominant hand. We take it into the 90 degree, make it a fist and push up, very good. Is his efficiency. That means he has efficiency assessed. Now I have to check which knee joint is affected. Put up the one hand up, I push it up. What happened? There is a 20-30% of power loss. Push it up, yeah, stronger. That means this knee is affected, it's identified. This method of applied kinesiology, not only by chiro, so different people use, kinesthetics people use, osteopath are using, and this method is highly reliable because of the matrix theory, tensegrity system. So for that, this assessment can perform. Now we could do, yes, it is a superior lateral, what I do? And make the patella superior and lateral. Now I have to push. So he lost the power, that means it subluxated superior and lateral. So now I push to downwards and medial, push it up. He got strength more, so come to know I'm going on the right direction. So how to do correction? So superior lateral to superior medial is very simple correction. It should be performed in the knee flexion methods. So how to make this? One option is sit up, come the edge, going inside, throw outside. So the therapist sits along with the patient and put a hand or leg on the up. This is the most comfortable position for everybody to perform in this direction. I will show you in the two methods. One hand pushing towards this one. So I put a hand, press down and cross. That means inferior medial direction. End, take the patient to breathe out. At the end, I could just give a thrust. So patella shifted from superior to inferior, lateral to medial. Now the question is, why you need to flex the knee joint? If it is this extended, they used to go back to his original position because of knee flexion will help the people, especially patella, slide towards medial and inferior. So clear, especially lateral superior correction, always flexed knee joint. So this position is very close to the patient. For corona, we need a good distance, social distance, and as well as area. So another method for like lie down on row. Supine. And flex the leg very gently. Same procedure from the face to face, we have the more than the meter distance. So it is the most preferred. And I push the same maneuver in inside. The end, we give wonderful thrust. If it is, how we can good adjust it. How we can do this method? take the heel, take the cover, push towards the medial and the end, breathe in and breathe out. You can hurt, there is a slight shifting. Put the leg down. See, it's once again, it's come to equal. The patella come to more medial than the lateral. If you want to correct any instrumental method, this is called activator. The instrument can use this. So very simply, flex the leg very nicely and bend it. And put in the pole from superior medial, cross diagonal, at the tens of 5 grade tension at the adjuster. And put it in a very gentle support. Click, click. So now addition is clear, followed by mobility. Yes. So once again, I want to teach you, don't teach isometrics. Because the isometric leads to more lateral frictions. So I want to say more eccentric and functional, open kinematic and closed kinematic will help much better. Especially humerus can strengthen by the very simple method, sit up, put the foot down, come, bench. Back. Edge of the area, put a towel on below, make it parallel and the, put the fist, make it closer, both are, you know it. Press it by hand. First, do it again and extend one leg, extend one leg. And this is the best method for VMO with adductor, because VMO is along with synergy of with adductor muscle. So we need to be added with adduction for knee extension, especially VMO strengthening. So from today onwards, we want to improve our VMO, then we will focus on more and more this. So this manual we learn wonderfully for how to correct the patellofemoral joint. So now what we are going to next one, that is called iliotibial tract. So how to get iliotibial tract? That's the most common lateral. Everybody's so lie down. Turn towards that side. So the iliotibial tract is one of the lateral pain. The come here, the musculature, then it has become a tendon and attached to the lateral portion of tibia. It walk in mid-knee. So make it a mid-knee. Just the lift the leg and put it down. Very relaxed. Put it down. Very nice. You can feel there is a strong musculature bond. It is called iliotibial tract. This is an iliotibial tract which is creating the dysfunction, especially in tibia for runners who are flexed in position, semi-flex area, who are the generalized lifestyle is not extension, complete extension is not achieved. How we go for release method? So one, give me a pen. When you see this tendon, it's the biggest tendon. It's the biggest tendon. So this method is MFR, myofascial release method. Next slide. Yeah, here. This is a lateral knee joint pain. It is IT band friction syndrome. It's a manual and MFR method. I'm going to show you how you can use this very nicely. Put a hand and leg very nice and comfortable. And pillow are given very nice and lie down. And privacy to be maintained. And take the tendon very nicely. Use one thumb to hold and use another thumb to hold. Press down and move together. Why? Because our Golgi tendon organ is the which one is we are activated by MFR for 90 seconds. You can see immediate effect. Why, sir? Why not we go for up or down? Because it is a tendon, long tendon. It's only stretch while come together of both thumb. This maintain 90 seconds and automatically inhibition is come up based on monosynaptic, especially it is called Golgi tendon organ, produce inhibitory in the musculature, then the complete relaxation, longer, slow adapting and longer duration get released. After that, you just check the muscle, you feel amazing changes, but you should consider, you should strengthen the VMO. And here,
isometric quadricep exercise is indication. You have to teach them isometric. Because end range of 10 degree extension is the most crucial of, next slide, most crucial of this area. So here we come with the two, one is patella, another one is iliotibial tract, the OME joint. It's before that OME joint, I want to show some of the this PPTs, you can come to know what are the different. What can be done with the conservative physiotherapy treatment? The correct the biomechanics. Here I'm adding one. The correct the biomechanics and kinesiological factor. So especially in physiotherapy, we are mostly dependent to equipment based, which will not help biomechanical correction or kinesiological correction. Maybe our strengthening program help in kinesiological, but biomechanical correction is the key of knee joint. Because of each and every research, especially in the recent research, Q angle, tibia femoral angle, tibial rotation, all are a major component. Even talus position, even arch, even weight bearing had a major role of ONE. So here we have the two important, that means foot wear alternatives and proper knee bracing is added. With the conservative method, we do every day this protocol. So how we can do this? Here we have this podia scan method, otherwise you can make it with electronic podia scan. This, the method is called Harrison method. We put ink and put a scanner. The scanner identifies how much percentage of weight bearing in this area. So if you see there is a too much at the lateral, too much of the lateral. So you come to know the patient get too much of weight bearing can be erected. So how we can get weight bearing can shifted to assess the joint space. For example, the healthy people, it's equal. The healthy people almost equal. But the OME, as per classification, this distance has come down. If it is less than 3, is called degeneration started. According to this degeneration, we can provide the lateral wedge ankle in the different way. How we can make in a different ankle? If we can make the degenerate ankle start from 2 degree, 3 degree, 4 degree and 5 degrees. 2 degrees general for balance between the medial and lateral weight bearing. For initially, the healthy people can make it. And third degree, that means the patient is developed grade 2 ONE patient, need to be 3 degree wedging is required. Then 4 degrees grade 3. But grade 4 degree, it's generally for us for called surgical. But in India, that's a developing country, the surgical is not affordable for everybody. So how we can make grade 3 and 4 is better? So here the 5 degree lateral wedge can produce ankle instability. So start with the 4 with the support of the knee brace. We have this wonderful knee braces. So we can how to make, you see this figure, we will make a wonderful leg. Here is 3mm is adopted, this wedge is given. You see the how the weight bearing can produce in the general worm activity. The lateral wedge can help equal weight bearing. That is also seen in wheel balancing in the normal lifestyle. So we have imbalance of the wheel or the tire. What we do? Make it the equal weight bearing. Here we can make on the lateral wedge according to the either degree, either mm. You can make it. Here you can see the brace, especially brace, medial opening brace work amazingly. We have the lot of level 2 evidences. Footwear and especially you, and you see these cases. When you says we can, all are different. The cases in especially medial joint space is reduced. The weight shifting can be performed in two methods. One is put it on wedges on lateral. The lateral wedge shifting weight bear from medial to lateral. The second option is put a brace. Nowadays is lot of mechanical braces available, especially in autobob. And especially dejo braces and the all ONE reduction of general varum shifting of the one. It is not me, the most of the world renowned article and journal, they prescribe the brace and level 2 evidences. And this evidences can help. So don't just give a support, especially the people use lot of kneecaps and braces are the fault. Too much of total differences. Weight shifting in the character is the most important. So for me, my patient, I will assess foot wear first and the type of weight bearing to be considered by two methods. One is static, another one is dynamic. How the weight bearing is shifting. That weight bearing shifting correction by early stages, especially grade 1, grade 2, I only prefer with the insoles, and grade 3 and 4 I prefer along with braces. Yes, especially grade 2. Here is, we can come to the AOMS again. Once here is the LS particular, without brace, there is a complete, with the lateral brace, there is an opening of the joint space. Both here, we have this biomechanical correction in seen in this one. The valgus brace designed to reduce the load of the area, medial compartment, applicable to external valgus. Movement of through the 3.4 system. It's a three work. It help in rotatory. It can produce a valgus force. It is also control the translation. An insole is the one type of treatment as medial joint. It is a physically applied stress. The wedge placing under the insole had a strong evidence as work. So now we have a method to how to make a rotation and corrections. Especially knee joint, you see the patient medially translated, the knee joint is good. Whenever it's going to the tibia is translated laterally, the femur translation medially, and it rotates externally. So what's my duty? The externally rotated tibia into medial and the lateral to medial, and especially posterior to anterior. Because of every patient, you can come to say there is a huge gap when you have extension. Lie down for the doctor, straight up, please. In OAD patient, especially, we put the hands here, there is a free motion, that means the full extension is not possible. So put the area, so the tibia is translation laterally because of genu varum. Translation laterally, rotated externally, as well as posterior. How we can do in a one maneuver into corrections? Lie down on pro. Check his both knee joint, it is externally rotated too much. Externally rotated. You put an inclinometer, you can see that is external. So flex the knee joint up to 90 degree. And use the hand making from rotate lateral to medial at a stretch. And lateral to medial, posterior to anterior. Together at the end, we go with click. Right? Breathe in. Breathe out. Okay. Finish. So now, you can check, both are equal. So especially ONE, we can correct this method, otherwise lie down straight. And we have this MW method from the Brad Mulligan, rotate and rotate with medially and laterally. That's why we use rotatory component. Wonderfully we do nicely. And you can open the joint space. And anterior translation can be achieved very nicely. And remaining exercise program, cycling more, less weight bearing exercise, gait correction, insole and bracing. We have the limited time, almost we completed. There is a lot to learn in this one. The last one maneuver I want to show, that is called the medial joint space problem. Come here, there. Holding the knee joint, the patient complaining there is a pinch in the medial aspect. So we choose this medial aspect, how to correct? One hand and hold it, use of distraction. This maneuver is developed by A.T. Still. One hand, you open the medial joint, the other hand closing the medial joint. So one, two, one, two, one, two. So open the knee joint and close it. So one, I'm going to maneuver, breathe in and breathe out. Good, one, good. Then hook the point. Perform this squeezing method. And automatically, there is a sliding of medial meniscus go back to its original places. In one maneuver, you get wonderfully developed. This is a reposition of medial meniscus. Will help the patient get wonderful correction, especially pinching at the medial joint space, coronary ligament imbalances, medial meniscus problem, medial collateral ligament problem. With the maneuver properly we do, with the bracing and proper healing. Here at the end of this whole class, we come to know there is knee joint and knee joint problem, and we how to examine it and how to correct the different type of work. With this is a wonderful time with you people. If you have any queries, and here is available that it can transfer and online. And especially thank you very much. But especially if need any clarification, doubts, question answer, anything you want to listen, you can mail me at Narkish@gmail.com, or also the Dr. Narkish YouTube channel is available. Go and see, you can get a lot of information, especially case studies, conditions, and everything. We are always open for anything to any queries I could rectify. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.